Right. Okay, folks, well, we're going to leave the area of outstanding beauty now, all up there, which I've walked a few minutes ago, all down through there, where those yellow gorse bushes are. I've just walked down through there where little lambs are being born in there. I walked through a field as well, which much further over was a huge bull. It was in with the sheep. It had massive horns. There's no other cows or herd or anything. I picked it up. I thought, goodness, thank God it won't go over this way more. You know, where I was walking. Right then, folks, we're going into Longwood now. I've got a feeling the wild garlic isn't out yet. So I'm just going to walk straight down through the middle. That's what I'm going to do. I think it's going to be another... See, this is the wild garlic. It's not going to be long. The buds are there. But it ain't out yet. It ain't out yet. Yeah. First time I've been in the wood with this camera. I've been up the steep Longwood pathway to Longfield. It's a bit of just about managed, I think, on the battery that's left in the charger. Camera didn't last as long. I charged it up. Sometimes it charges up for longer. See, it isn't going to be long. There's a little bit of wild garlic there, look. If you look over there, that's going to be a blanket of white soon. You often wonder what this bit was with the wall here, look. Wall there. Don't you? See, somebody might know what all that's about. I can smell the wild garlic, which I can't capture on the camera, but I can smell it. All these plants here are wild garlic. The bluebells have already started to come out somewhere. I haven't seen any here yet. It's usually the end of April, beginning of May, when you've got to catch. I've done it a couple of years now. I've been here. I've been lucky. And it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful, like a gold, like a white jewel with blue tinges with the bluebells. But this bit here is just one mass of white. Because it's not out properly yet, I'm not going to go walking up in and out the wood bit. All I'm going to do today is... I'm going to walk down through the valley. And I'll come back another... I'll come back. I reckon be still safe in 2 weeks' time. It might... You've got to catch it right. See, I don't want to come out in a week and it's still not quite there. So I'd leave it at least a fortnight now before I come out. I'm going to... It's beautiful. And you just wonder why these walls... You know, what all this is about here, like, you know, there's a lot of history here, a lot of history. And I videoed this with some sweet little cameras in the past. But of course, most of it's me, it's jump there, usually jumpy, I talk too much as well. You'll get deer in here. I'm going to try and do what I call a quieter walk. I'm going to do a quieter walk. So I heard a stick break then. It's either human or when someone treads on a twig. I haven't actually been in the wood for quite a while because I haven't needed to. over the little troll bridge in a second. Longwood Nature Reserve. There's potholes everywhere around here, apparently. Ooh, little work there. Either the birds come out or somebody's at it. There's another one there. I would have known, as a kid, I would have known what sort of bird that was, you know. I used to know all the colours of the eggs, the specks on them and everything. This mossy old bridge, look. Very mossy. The land that time forgot. It's beautiful though, isn't it? When I get to the end, I'll have a drink. When I get to the end of this. You can still see, while the leaves are on the trees, you can actually see a lot. But give a month, this will be darker as well, because it'll be a canopy over the top. At the moment though, it gets all the light for all these lovely flowers are all getting ready to come out. More streams, more water. Because I've done a running history of this place in the past. Waterboard. That's all to do with the waterboard in there. And normally I climb up and weave in and out the trees. There's a pathway further up, but I'm not going to do that today. Look, they've put a new gate on. That's interesting, isn't it? That must still have a function, that thing, you know. Some sort of pump. Must still, unless they have to lock it up. I mean, people get in there if they want to get in there. That bolt won't stop them. But they have to put it on there, I suppose. Cover themselves. This is station 4, if you come on the organised walk. Looks like a few trees have fallen. And they sometimes have people that are like wardens in here, and I think there's like somebody watching the animals, like a hide. There was an encampment up here somewhere. Apparently they were something to do with observing the animals. Well, it's not running down here, is it? I wonder where it goes to then. They must divert it back there somewhere, mustn't they? A stream. Normally then I go up there which I won't do now because nothing's out. The bluebells aren't out and neither are the snowdrops. And not only that, when you're up the top there, which is where the long field is, up the top, you can hear people talking. So, you know, so can the deer hear you, Sheila. Path up there, I've never tried as well.